a day, do you find yourself fascinated with the exceptional, the unusual, the abnormal? Psychological disorders, characterized by odd behaviors and dysfunctional, unjustifiable actions. Now, let's go to Megan and Oliver C. Dangles, who's been diagnosed with an anxiety disorder. An anxiety disorder being, let's see, yes. An anxiety disorder which is distressing, persisting anxiety or uncommon behaviors. Megan?
One, two, three, four, five.
I think it's close. Just have a seat.
Oh, of course.
Thank you for joining us, Mr. Oliver Dangles.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Sorry I was late.
So, can you tell me a little bit about your anxiety disorder?
Well, I was diagnosed 10 years ago with obsessive compulsive disorder. My compulsive urges became a problem when it started to interfere with my daily activities.
Exactly how was your life altered by your diagnosis?
My constant obsessions of thoughts led me to take repetitive actions to the point where I was never able to get out of the house on time.
So then are you one of those people who's concerned about locking doors and stepping over the cracks on the sidewalks and washing your hands 24/7?
I find myself closing doors several times and I'm constantly checking my physical appearance.
So would you consider this a phobia?
Oh, no. A phobia is more of a persistent irrational fear and avoidance of an object or situation. Mine is more of an obsession where I have unwanted repetitive thoughts.
Do you find it easy to manage your career with these obsessive thoughts?
In fact, I was fired from my last job for always showing up late due to my compulsions. Actually, the other day I had such an intense fear that I left the burner on in my house that I experienced a panic attack.
I don't know much about panic attacks. Can you elaborate on that for me?
Well, I became short of breath, my chest felt tight, I started sweating. Basically, it felt like a heart attack. Apparently, I found out at the hospital that if you have several of these attacks, you can develop a panic disorder.
Wow, that sounds awfully traumatic. Well, thank you for sharing your story with us, Mr. Dangles. It was a pleasure, and I wish you the best.
Oh, you're welcome.
Anxiety disorders are now considered to be the result of learning and biological perspectives. The learning perspective sees anxiety disorders as a product of fear conditioning, stimulus generalization, reinforcement, and observational learning. The biological perspective considers evolutionary, genetics, and physiological influences.
Don't get out of life.
Hey, watch it. Don't touch! Hey!
Thanks, Barb. Now, let's go talk to Amy. She has a little bit to say about mood disorders, huh?
Hi, I'm talking to Jackie today, who is a nurse and a single mother who struggles with a major depressive disorder. It's a type of mood disorder, and what a mood disorder is a psychological disorder characterized by emotional extremes. So Jackie, could you give us a description of what a major mood disorder is?
Basically, I've been depressed for a few months. I have no motivation or energy to even get out of bed some days, or reason to live. I have trouble eating and sleeping normally. I have lost interest in caring for my son and my patients. These are some common characteristics of major depressive disorder.
How did the doctors diagnose you with a major depressive disorder?
Because I had been depressed for more than 2 weeks, and there was no specific cause, the doctor diagnosed me with major depressive disorder. I was beyond just feeling blue and down in the dumps. The feeling of being down in the dumps on most days for 2 or more years is dysthymic disorder.
What kind of treatment did the doctor recommend?
The doctor gave me a prescription for an antidepressant, as well as the names of some psychotherapists in the area.
Has these things been working for you?
Yes. I've started enjoying life again. As a nurse, I know the importance of taking my medications as directed and not suddenly stopping. I read an article in Nursing called Is Your Patient Depressed? That discussed the importance of this.
Thanks for sharing with us, Jackie. Now it's time for Rachel, who is an art student at the University of Alberta, and she's diagnosed with bipolar disorder.
Basically, it's depression with a bit of spice. See, I experience manic episodes, and then depressive episodes, and then manic episodes, and then depressive episodes. It just goes on and on. Well, when I'm having a manic episode, I'm hyperactive, and it's like I'm on high, and I just go, and talk, and I just can't stop moving, and I can paint like Michelangelo, and it's just amazing.
Can you describe this high?
Well, let me tell you, I've had sex with 22 people in the last month. It's great. Well, my other friends, when they're going through the manic thing, they go on huge shopping sprees, and I haven't slept in 3 days. Oh, did you know that Ernest Hemingway and Poe were also bipolar?
Wow, so what about that depression state, Rachel?
It's like I'm in a fog and can't really see clearly, and no reason to live, and I don't know, the roller coaster will never end. It's my fault that I can't kick this depression. I just can't. It's hopeless.
I've heard that when a person is depressed, they are more likely to commit suicide.
It is true that when people are depressed, they might want to end their life, but when they're deep in depression, then often they don't even have the energy to do anything, and so they can't even kill themselves. But often it's when they're feeling better that's when it happens. And yeah, I've been hospitalized 3 times for attempted suicide, and I've attempted it numerous times, but no one. Men are more likely to succeed. Lucky them. So.